Some people have met their money quotas, but they're still not able to use the money to do what they want with it. What am I speaking about? I let Rhondall Feeles, president of the Single Fathers Association of Trinidad and Tobago, explain the situation a little more. Good morning, Mr. Feeles.
Morning, DK. How are you doing?
I'm all right, thank you, but not everyone is doing so well. What is the situation that you're promoting right now?
Yeah, well, the issue happening is an issue that we even experienced with Jerome Henry, who we assisted getting the bail at the Port of Spain Magistrate Court. It's an issue that a mother came to us, actually. A mother and a wife. Her husband has been incarcerated. He's also a father. That's why we got involved in the first place. He's been incarcerated and granted bail. Bail has been set since in March for the sum of $10,000, cash bail in the sum of $10,000. What we're seeing happening at the court is that the clerk of the peace tree has a protocol. Yes, we understand that it's under her discretion that she allows bail and she facilitates bail. But we're seeing that bail is being granted at the sum of $10,000. And these people aren't allowed to access this bail unless they can show a balance of $10,000 or the bail amount for the last 6 months. This, DK, is something that is very hard for a poor or even a middle-class person to do. So what this protocol being put in place is actually saying to the general public that if you are an offender or if your children are offenders and you are rich, then you can access bail. But if you are poor, then you will waste away in prison. And I think something needs to be done about this. I think this needs to be addressed by the Chief Justice or whoever is in charge of the clerk of the peace tree. Reason being, I can see three salient points and three concerns that the public should have. First of all, we are saying that there's overcrowding in Rayman Yard. The prison is overcrowded. When there are people that have the money, this woman I'm speaking about, DK, has had this $10,000 since March. But she's a hairdresser, receives money over the counter, and has been unable to bail her husband because she can't show it being in her account. Right? So there are people that have the resources, have the money to access bail, and are not being allowed to do so because they don't satisfy the clerk of the peace tree.
But Rhondall, secondly, just before you go to your second point, if she's had the money since March, and it's supposed to be in the account for 6 months, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, we're in November now. But doesn't that satisfy it?
No, but she would have had to deposit it in the account. And at the end of the day, DK, if you have $10,000 today since March, you wouldn't have to spend out of it some point in time. She must have to spend, and then even if it was in the account and she had it, $10,000, it must not drop under $10,000 in the account, you know. That is the problem, because she has attempted with other people as well. Other people has gone, and because they could not show the balance of $10,000, they had a problem. She went with her brother-in-law, who's a businessman, and she was told that he had too much money. So then what is the true justification? And this is a very serious issue. And DK, my problem with that six-month thing is because there are good ways. People, the justification that many of the people in the court may say is that, here what, we don't know if these people rob people. We don't know where they get this $10,000 from. It could have been a bad means by which they allocated the $10,000. But what I am saying is that it could have been a very good means that they allocated it as well. There are fundraising events, cake sales, barbecues, a number of ways. There are donations. Sometimes a person here, the history family going through and come forward to pay. There's the family coming together. A sister have 4,000, a brother have 5,000, a wife have 1,000, and they come together and get $10,000. Why isn't this being allowed as a satisfactory way to access bail? This is a very common way that people would look together to bail their loved ones at a cash, with a cash bail. If we all could put up together and go to the court, or if we have a fundraising event and go to the court, I believe the clerk of the peace duty is to facilitate the bail. The magistrate is the one that sets the bail. And once the magistrate is convinced that, hey, this person, no matter what the offense, can be released on a bail that at this price, this is what the clerk of the peace tree must facilitate. Yes, she must receive a check that is a certified check and must appear to be a good and a valid check. I agree with that. But studying the allocation of the funds is the job that I believe that the police should do. A very worthy suggestion that would hold everybody into compliance is having an affidavit sworn as into where the money has come from. If the police, for some reason, become suspicious and decide to do an investigation and realize that the person came and took the bail, got the funds from a bad area, let the police do the investigation and then the police prosecute, and then you have a sworn affidavit that you could prosecute the person with.
This is highly subjective.
The thing is, what I'm saying, DK, is that if it is the current way that it is right now, it would mean that only people who can maintain that balance of $10,000, people who may be wealthy and have $100,000 in their account every single time, only them and their children or their friends will be able to access bail because of their financial position. If bail is being set, bail is to allow every single person, no matter their socioeconomic standing, to access freedom. It should not be for those who could qualify, and those who can't qualify have to sit down in a prison. That is my issue. If you're setting bail, you set bail, and you make it accessible to all. That is the reason I believe they set bail. You understand?
Definitely.
So the other two points is that if we overcrowd any prison, we already saying we're looking for all other ways to raise revenue, raising money on cigarettes, raising money on alcohol. But the public purse is being drained by maintaining people in the prison system who have the resources to leave the prison system because they have the money to access bail. And our money is mining people in prison who have access to bail and who have resources to be bailed. And because it's not satisfying, the six-month period are still being kept inside of the prison. So it's an automatic drain on the public purse as well.
Your third point, Mr. Feeles.
And finally, it is against, if a man is given the opportunity to be free or access to freedom, it is his right and constitutional right to access it, to be free. If there's a way for him to become free, and the magistrate has set a bail from the court, I do not believe the clerk of the peace tree. It seems as if the clerk of the peace tree, to some extent, would appear to be as if she can override the bail being set by not accepting it. And I think that the system needs to be reviewed. I don't care what the rule is or what the system is or what the protocol is or the practice. It needs to be reviewed because clearly there would be two persons, one rich person and one poor person that committed the very same offense. The rich person will be able to access his bail and the poor person would not. And that is a failure of the system in my view.